Thank you. What I want to do is briefly share some thoughts about moving large corporate projects to Apache based on the experiences of moving NetBeans to Apache. So you may or may not know, but there is, since October 2016, in the Apache incubator, there is Apache NetBeans. And the process of moving NetBeans into Apache out of Oracle has been quite long and painful. And I've reflected a bit on that process, and I want to share the key learnings from it, and hopefully useful for other projects, other organizations moving projects either to Apache or to some other foundation. So my name is Geert-Jan. I was working in Sun Microsystems in Prague, and I was mainly working there as a technical writer for NetBeans, so the development environment, working on documentation and tutorials and things like that for describing how to use it. And also beneath NetBeans there is a generic framework, and I was going around to different companies and explaining how to use that as the basis of software. And of course there was the takeover by Oracle, and then NetBeans became part of Oracle. And inside Oracle I've been working as a product manager focused on the JavaScript strategy that Oracle has. So front-end JavaScript, Oracle has a technology stack, and it's called JET, so I've been working on that. That's about me. So what I want to do is I want to give a very brief history of NetBeans as an example of a large project. And I want to focus in particular on governance aspects. The point here about NetBeans being a large project, we can actually see, if you look in the on the statistics page of projects@apache.org, you can see on that page. I can see. You can't switch. Or interesting. It's okay. It's okay. You can sit down again. So I'll share that later. Anyway, if you look on the Apache NetBeans project page, you'll see that NetBeans is one of the larger projects in Apache right now. So what I want to do is I want to briefly talk about the history of NetBeans, focusing on its governance, and explain how NetBeans ended up being in Apache in the first place, what the process was to get there, and from that extract some generic helpful tips for anyone else going through a similar process. So first of all, NetBeans as a development environment has been around for a very long time. It was the first development environment for Java, created in about 96, 97 by a group of students in Prague. And it was basically a student project that got out of hand, and it was used more and more broadly. It was acquired by Sun, and it was open sourced in 2000. However, even though it was open source, it wasn't open governance. And that is one of the key points I want to make here, is that what Apache brings to the project, to the NetBeans project, is not open source, because NetBeans has always been open source, but what it brings is a governance structure. That's a key advantage that it brings to a project of that size in particular. So, but despite the fact that it's always been governed by Sun, and the decision making and the roadmap was always defined by Sun, there was always a very strong focus on community. So, what I'm basically doing is I'm going to start by giving a brief history of NetBeans as an example of a large project. Explain how it ended up inside Apache, explain the current state, and extract from that 10 generic tips that could be useful for someone else going through a similar process. So NetBeans was founded in 96, a group of students in Prague created it. It was seen by James Gosling at a conference, and it was acquired, it became part of Sun. But in terms of governance, everything was driven by Sun. The roadmap, the direction, the new features, contributions were sought for, but not readily provided, or not very much, because constantly there was this idea, okay, if I contribute code to NetBeans, I'm essentially helping Sun. There wasn't that much of a, that didn't really create much of a desire for organizations or individuals to be involved in the project. However, despite that, a really strong community grew around NetBeans, which is kind of a magical thing. Since again, you know, it was really a Sun-driven project. On the other hand, of course, Sun was always very much focused on community. It wasn't a typical large international organization. It was really focused on community building, and NetBeans was used by Sun as a tool to enable that. And so, despite the fact that Sun is, you know, was really a, you know, commercial company in many senses, this community developed around it. And in particular, there were two programs that were very interesting and that are still of relevance in the context of Apache that started in the 90s, early 2000s. One is called NetCat, the NetBeans Community Acceptance Testing Program, which is a group, has always been a group of volunteers in the NetBeans community who take the official test specifications from the engineers and they go through these test specifications, and that NetCat, that volunteer community, they would decide when NetBeans would be released. So they would do a go or no go. So in a sense, they were already behaving like an Apache type structure already. So in the same way as within an Apache project, the mailing list and the PMC together decides when a release is ready in consultation with the IPMC and the incubator. That kind of process was actually already happening way back in the early days of NetBeans in Sun via this NetCat program. So we had a structure that was basically the basic germ of that idea. And secondly, what there also always was something called the NetBeans Dream Team, and that was an organization or an official organization of individual enthusiasts, not paid by Sun, who went around the world to conferences and who would do the demos when they were talking about Java EE or whatever they were talking about. They would do the demos in NetBeans and they would say, NetBeans is cool and I belong to the Dream Team. And there was like a whole brand around this Dream Team concept. It was kind of an evangelism team for NetBeans, unpaid by Sun, despite Sun being a commercial organization. So there were all these, there were several little groups and elements of an Apache-like structures were already baked into NetBeans from the very beginning. Initially it was all about Java, and then more and more languages and technologies were supported over time as other technologies arose. At the same time, this platform was heavily used as well. So the infrastructure of NetBeans isn't only the infrastructure of NetBeans IDE, but it's also the infrastructure of software at Boeing and at NASA and at Airbus, and a lot of large enterprises need to create large systems for which the browser is not well suited, and they create those systems on the desktop, and the NetBeans platform as a Java Swing framework is very suitable for that. So a lot of what I've been doing over the years is going to large enterprises and talking about the NetBeans APIs, which again was very useful. The fact that NetBeans has always had APIs and a modular system has proved to be very useful, because the people that we had been training all these years about the APIs, about creating plugins, about creating applications on that framework, are now the strongest committers inside the Apache NetBeans project. So our strongest committers are people who have been learning the APIs and using the APIs for 20 years already. It's not like we have to build up a new community. We've had this NetCat, this volunteer testing community. We've had a volunteer evangelism community, and we've been going around the world for 20 years or more, teaching people to use the APIs, to use the architecture, the plugin system, the platform, and so on. So all these things have proved to be really useful and explain how NetBeans now is the way it's now working inside of Apache. So then there was, of course, the transition to Oracle. So there was the acquisition of Sun by Oracle, and NetBeans was part of that acquisition. And the very first thing that we in Prague, working on NetBeans, thought was, well, that's the end of NetBeans, because Oracle was invested in, definitely in JDeveloper, Oracle's own development environment, but also in Eclipse. And then there was NetBeans, you know, three tools essentially doing the same thing, and by the same company, and a company not known for throwing money out the window. So something needed to be done, and obviously we were the last ones in, so we thought we'd be the very first ones out, and that the first decision that Oracle would make would be, well, thank you very much, but we're not doing NetBeans anymore, which never happened. Instead, what happened is that a lot of the Oracle tools ended up being re-architected on top of NetBeans. So JDeveloper, if you're familiar with Oracle JDeveloper, when you start it up now, you'll see you get lots of bootstrapping messages from the NetBeans module system, because JDeveloper has been re-architected on top of NetBeans, and a lot of tools within JDeveloper come from NetBeans. And also, Oracle Visual VM is based on top of NetBeans. So there's a whole range of different tools. And JDeveloper itself is a platform for other tools. SQL Developer on top of JDeveloper, on top of NetBeans. So NetBeans has had a lot of different useful functional roles within Oracle. And at the same time, in addition to that, NetBeans continued to be positioned by Oracle as the official IDE for Java. And also, at the time of the takeover, we were working on NetBeans 6.9.1.2 or something. And Oracle said, hey, but we're releasing Java 7, aren't we? So why don't we call NetBeans NetBeans 7? And Oracle was the one that made the decision to align the NetBeans releases with the Java releases. So and continued developing it for many years. And in addition to that, JavaScript became more and more important. So what I've been doing as a JavaScript product manager, essentially, in Oracle, is going around to conferences and companies talking about Oracle's JavaScript solution, and what we use for our demonstrations and so on is NetBeans. So NetBeans has all kinds of different interesting places within Oracle. So on the one hand, you know, we have this very complex situation at that point. You know, we have this Sun-driven community-oriented tool, Netcat, this Dream Team, all these different structures. And now we're in Oracle, and Oracle's different places for it. But there was this continual pressure. Really, the main pressure came from the community. All these people who had been working with NetBeans all these years and voluntarily going to conferences and promoting NetBeans and testing NetBeans, and we had set up NetBeans days so all over the world. The principle has always been once a month, somewhere in the world, there should be a NetBeans event of some kind. And it's never actually been achieved, but that's kind of the aim. And so there's a NetBeans Day London, a NetBeans Day Paris, NetBeans Day Athens. And sometimes there's, you know, around 120 people, sometimes it's about 50, 60, it's around that, who come to those events. So there was this, but at some point there was this clear pressure from this community. Hey, we've been, you know, actively supporting this project. We really want to be involved in the roadmap. We really know what NetBeans wants. And why does Oracle, and before that Sun, decide on their own, essentially? Okay, we can do enhancement requests and we can do bug reports, but essentially, end of the day, it's the company behind it that decides which features go into the product. And sure, we can create plugins and so on. That's all side stories. We want to be involved in the direction of the project as a whole. And that was a continual pressure. A second thing, that's a simple fact of life, is Oracle is not a tools organization. Oracle is a database organization and increasingly a cloud organization. So a free open source tool, whether free and open source or not, a commercial tool, a tool as such, is kind of a strange animal in the Oracle stack. So that kind of combination of factors, plus this in Oracle continual move into the cloud, everything is in the cloud, and there you have this tool that's on the desktop. So it's kind of it became increasingly strange animal in the zoo as such. And so so that kind of like this pull and push situation arose over years, and it never really culminated into anything, into any particular decision. But what comes along with it, of course, is that an organization like Oracle makes decisions as well on the resourcing level. And then, you know, Oracle is a kind of you know, a lot of these large enterprises are not really product focused, but they're project focused. So they say, well, you've worked on this for a while, now we put you onto another project. And then that has an impact on products. So that means it's really a product, it's not a project. So that kind of resourcing also tended to have sometimes consequences as well. So all these different factors together led to a decision in October 2016. Look, maybe we can do it in a better way. I mean, clearly the community wants more from this tool than we in Oracle want from it. So let's share the cost of ownership. That was really the idea. Right now there's about half the people who are working on the product are somehow connected to Oracle. So that whole Oracle investment remains. But clearly, as you'll see when I talk about this a bit more, the Apache move has really brought in a whole bunch of other people who hadn't been involved before. So it's really worked out for the best. And actually, it's something that I wish had happened 20 years ago. I mean, I wish Sun had put NetBeans into Apache, because NetBeans is really the kind of project that fits into an Apache structure, because we are really community focused, and it's kind of a strange project in that sense, coming to Apache, because normally a project goes to Apache in order to get it, to build a community. You know, you have a product, you've worked on some technology together, and then you think, okay, it needs a wider audience. Let's move to Apache and build a community around it and a governance model, etc. But we already had a community. So this is one reason why, despite how long it's taking, people are still motivated, because they're very attached to the product. So then the incubator proposal was put together. There was a long list of committers. After that, there was a bit of a silence. So this was around Java 1 in 2016. A bit of a radio silence from Oracle. We're trying to figure out, how do we do this? Okay, we've decided we're going to donate this to Apache, but what does that mean? What is NetBeans? You know, is it the tool? Is it the website? Is it, you know, what is really involved? What about the mailing list? And suddenly it's like, okay, and it's kind of like spirals out into so many other, okay, what about the bug tracker? What about this? What about that? And really figuring out what is NetBeans becomes a question, and figuring out a process. How do we donate? What does it mean to donate? And figuring out after that decision, figuring out the next steps definitely took a couple of months. And then there was a process established that the code needed to be audited, so that we really would know for sure that the code that we are giving to Apache really belongs to Oracle. So in the NetBeans toolbar, there's a icon for opening the Google browser. That icon is a Google icon, a Google trademark. Can Oracle donate Google's trademarks to Apache? No. So that means we should look at every single file to make sure that we can donate each of those files to Apache, which means we have, you know, millions of files to look at. And then we need to establish a process, and we had scripts to check the copyright notices, but many of them didn't have a copyright notice, so we had to check them by hand, and we had to look at the images, and it was, you know, and it's still ongoing. So we've done the first donation. At some point, we decided to split the donation into different parts, and fortunately, we have a modular architecture, which is a key. Without the modularity, this would have not worked at all. But so we decided we won't wait until we've audited everything, because by then we'll all be old and etc. We want to do this in reasonable time frames. So let's split up the donation to smaller parts. So we donated the first part last year, and aside from OpenOffice, we're the largest project in Apache right now, and we're very close to OpenOffice, and we have at least a third more coming. So it's really a large project in Apache terms. So definitely we have a number of achievements, despite the fact that we are partway through the process. We had a number of incubator releases already. We're in the incubator. It's a really wonderful place to be. We are figuring out how all the processes work. You know, what does it mean to be in Apache? And it's really kind of it's this testing environment where we can just play and figure out what we are doing there. And how do we do releases? And we are learning how to be a community in the Apache context and getting feedback from especially our mentors, which has been fantastic. So we've completed a number of releases, not yet a major release. So right now we're working on Apache NetBeans 9. And the plan originally was that we would release Apache NetBeans 9 together with Java 9. And of course, in the meantime, Java 11 has been released. So the wonderful release cycle that has been introduced into Java will be good for NetBeans, but right now isn't so good for NetBeans. But I think this will enable us to release at least as frequently as the Java releases once we are fully into the Apache process. But initially we were really putting pressure on every part of this process because we wanted to release together with Java 9. That was the aim. And then Java 9 came and went, and Java 10 came and went, and so we kind of like, well, we'll release Apache NetBeans 9 whenever we are ready to be released. We're not going to be constrained by a deadline anymore. We just work as hard as we can to get it done. And then once we are really in there with all the code, then we're looking at, it would be great, it's just an idea, but like every 2 months, 2 or 3 months, have a new release, a new minor release, why not? That kind of release frequency is going to really be possible within Apache and benefit the project. So there's a new website. The old website is still there, so it's kind of interregnum. The old is still here and the new hasn't yet been born. So the old website is still there, and we're in the process of donating the brand to Apache. And once we've donated the brand and the domain to Apache, the netbeans.org, the domain will belong to Apache, and we will reroute it to netbeansapache.org. So we'll have one single site, and both of these URLs will link to the same place. Blog is up, logo and splash screen. You know, we have a lot of new code. It's all going pretty well. So this is the background. So now I want to move on to the promise of the presentation, the 10 tips. And they're slightly bleak, I must warn you. 10 slightly bleak tips. So first of all, these tips come out of everything I've said, but I'm going to expand on them and tell you a few interesting stories. So first, the first tip, and it's all about anticipation. You see that the first word in each of these is basically to anticipate. So first, the first tip is anticipate that the value of the project will decrease within the donating company together with urgency, etc. When a company decides to donate whatever it is to whoever it is, immediately the value of that project in that company is going to go down to zero because that company, it's on the way out, right? So you have to really be aware of this. And in retrospect, you need to really make some clear decisions inside the organization, who's going to be responsible, who's going to stick with this in the process, what the process consists of, really document it and stick to it and so on. I'm not sure if we could have done it, if retrospectively we could have done things very differently, but it would have been nice to have thought about that before saying, yes, let's go ahead with this, to have said, well, what does this mean? How much commitment are we going to be able to provide to this on the higher levels of decision making? You know, where will any requests for approvals lie in your stack of approvals and those kinds of things? So, but that's something to be aware of. Your project will no longer be at least as important as it used to be when a company decides to donate your project somewhere else. Second thing is, anticipate that the larger the group of people involved, the more complex the transition will be. Okay, so in retrospect, again, it would have been very nice to have had a small group of very specific people, like 5 or 6 people, and with very specifically assigned tasks and a clear line of command. You know, once we are at this stage, we will let you know, and then you will do this. All of that, it kind of everything happened very organically, and it's kind of anathema in a process of this length. So a lot of people were involved, and I'm just talking on the Oracle side now. I'm not even talking on the Apache side, where there's another whole bunch of people who are involved in different ways. And then there's pressure from the community, and there's pressure from both sides about where are you in this process, and the extent to which you can reveal where things are on the legal side, and all these kinds of things. Next thing is, anticipate, this is very important, anticipate that you will need to factor in significant time for miscommunications, confusion, and unexpected delays. So I would say, if you estimate that whatever the process is, whatever the length of time is, if you say it's going to be a year, I would say, depending on the size of the project, with the increasing size of the project, I would say make it times two, just for the miscommunications between all the levels of the organization that are involved. I mean, you have legal people, you have corporate architecture people, you have developers, you have product managers, and suddenly, within a large organization, other groups pop up to say, hey, what are you doing? You're moving this to Apache? We weren't involved, and what's going on? And suddenly, all kinds of new interests pop up, and discussions ensue, and this is a significant thing to be aware of, the kind of the unknown unknowns. I mean, there are always things that you know that you don't know, but you should figure out some time for allocate time for the things that you don't know, basically. The fourth point is anticipate that the sponsors of the donation will not be there forever. So you're inside a large organization, IBM, Oracle, or whatever, and there's this amazing VP who is promoting this idea of donating this, and you're very happy. But like a year later, that VP is gone. Or 6 months later, that VP is gone for whatever reason. And then there you are, and that VP who had all the contacts on the higher levels within the company is no longer there. And you know, your donation story was kind of low on their level of handing over to somebody else. And then, you know, you're kind of writing emails to people saying, hey, please respond, whereas that VP would have just called them and said, do it. But you know, suddenly that level of impact is out of the picture. Just be aware that the people who are promoting this on the highest level within a large organization are not going to be there forever, especially when your process takes a long time. So, fifth point is, anticipate that you may want to donate in stages. So I've said this. This is really key, especially with a large project and you find out that things are taking a long time. Consider splitting it up into smaller pieces. It's wonderful. This is the best thing about NetBeans in this process, that it's been modular from the beginning. So we can say, well, these modules together, that's the core platform. Let's donate that as one unit in the first donation. Okay, and let's add also all the tools for doing Java development so that we have some user features available. So not just a platform, but also features for doing Java development. So we were able to do that. So anticipate that you may want to donate in stages. So make sure that you have an architecture that is ready for a donation process, really. The sixth point is, anticipate that your community has different levels of knowledge, interest, and involvement. It's maybe an obvious thing, but you know, there's going to be people on the mailing lists who you kind of hope would do more, but their level of interest is different to your expectation. Or especially in this, we're at this lengthy critical stage of this long process, you know, we can see on the mailing list that people are saying, well, why doesn't NetBeans support JUnit 5 yet? And then my response and other people who are really involved with this process say, well, look, what we're focusing on right now is IP clearance. And then this user says, I don't care about IP clearance. And then we say, well, yes, you do, but you don't realize it. But we can't release without that. This is far more important than JUnit 5 support. So kind of like, you have to constantly keep explaining what is a priority right now in this particular lengthy process, and keep them attached to the project, and hopefully they won't go away. I mean, the longer the process takes, the greater the likelihood that people will leave. On the other hand, if the process takes really long, maybe they'll come back. You know? And that's what we see as well. It's like people saying, wow, this is taking a long time, but you guys are clearly committed. And then we say, well, you are part of you guys. You know, we're doing this together, and we need you to be involved. And I think by constantly re-emphasizing that they are part of this process, and this is the main advantage of being in Apache that there's not a company making a roadmap, but it's us that we do that together. It's really an inspiring thing, and it keeps people involved. And related to community, the stronger that your community is at the start, the better and more resilient it will be through the process. So we've been really fortunate that we've been building up this community forever. And they've been involved from the very beginning, and these community testers, people from that community testing project have said, hey, how do we fit into Apache? So we have made a separate Netcat mailing list of NetBeans community acceptance testing. And of course, they can't decide anymore go or no go, because the Apache process is different to how it was in Sun and in Oracle. But they can contribute to that process. So their go or no go will be fed in to the Apache process within the PPMC and the IPMC. So if the Netcat people say, no, it's not ready, then we will not start a vote thread on the Apache PPMC mailing lists. So we can actually combine this structure, which is completely foreign to Apache. We can combine it, and those people are doing the testing, so that's wonderful. And they've had years of testing experience with NetBeans as well, because they've been involved for so long. Other thing is, anticipate that your idealism may be tempered by cold, hard realities. So, a very clear example of this is the idea that at least I had for a while was, let's get schools involved in a logo competition for NetBeans. So we need to have a new logo. Wouldn't it be wonderful, because there are, you know, NetBeans is widely used at schools, we have a lot of contacts at schools, so let's get them involved in the process and let's get them to design logos. On the other hand, how long will that take? And we do want to release sometime, you know, before the end of this century. So what happened in the end was some really super amazing guy popped up on Twitter and said, hey, I have a couple of interesting logo designs that you could consider. And then one or two other people said, yeah, me too. And then we had five or six, right? We hadn't written to hundreds of schools. We just got like five or six randomly on Twitter. And we didn't exactly vote, but we kind of said, look, here we have five or six logos. They're in the issue. We discussed it. You don't need to vote all the time if you can come to agreement together. And so we discussed it on the mailing list, and everyone kind of agreed, yeah, this particular one is good. And so there we had the logo. So this works. Not ideal. Maybe we should do another. We should create another logo once we're really inside Apache and do it in a more idealistic manner. This point is very, very important. Anticipate that you will want to take a few moments now and then just to appreciate how far you've come and enjoy the moments where things are actually moving forward. You know, when things are actually moving, and when they're moving forward slowly. So even when they're moving forward, things are moving slowly. But at least when you're aware, wow, things are actually moving forward, it's something to appreciate, especially when it takes a really long time, that you kind of think, wow, it's still moving forward, and people are still actively moving the cheese or whatever it is. And then in the end, a final tip in this is anticipate that you will be enormously thankful for everything Apache provides. I mean, one is the mentors, but just the whole infrastructure. One key example is in NetBeans inside Oracle and inside Sun, there was like one guy who could do release management. And he had all kinds of weird scripts, and he threw a release together. I'm sure that this is true for many organizations. There's like this one amazing guy who knows everything about doing release management of the project. And you know that if that guy gets run over by a bus, that's the end of the project, you know. But in Apache, everything is described and documented. And one of our most recent incubator release was done by one of our community members. So for the first time, we've actually released NetBeans, okay, in the Apache incubator, but completely driven by a community member, not by somebody from Oracle Sun, not somebody who's been there forever, not by somebody who gets paid for doing it. And it's a little bit of a painful process, and all kinds of things that need to be done. And we have a script or a description of how to do that. And this person went through it, Emilian Bold from the community, which is, you know, just fantastic. And we're looking forward to having maybe every release having a different, because when we said, hey, does somebody want to manage the release? he popped up, but then in the next few days, two or three other people popped up and said, yeah, I'd like to do it too. So we really have some amazing developers with deep knowledge of the system and desire to commit to the project as well, which is great. But yeah, Apache provides mailing lists. So we moved all our mailing lists to Apache. We have a blog on Apache. You know, when we have problems about infrastructure, there's this little chat window you can go to. You know, when people are not responding to your issues from the infrastructure side, you can interact directly with the Apache infrastructure people. It's amazing, all the different and you know, we're taking up about 3% of the disk space if you look at where we are, and in the end probably about 5% by the time we get to having everything in Apache. So, and all for free. It's really incredible. So those were my tips for corporate projects moving to Apache, and just a little plug about NetBeans specifically. So we have this website. You can try out the release. We are actually, since we're in Apache, we are here to support Apache, other Apache projects. So NetBeans has great support for Apache Maven out of the box. It's really known as the best tool for doing Maven development, Apache Ant, Apache Groovy, but there's, you know, hundreds of other Apache projects. There could be templates, there could be tutorials built into NetBeans, code templates, snippets, all kinds of integrations are imaginable with NetBeans being in Apache, being the one and only development tool in Apache. So these would be the 10 tips I would leave you with. They're a little bit bleak, but they're at the same time really realistic, and it's a long road, but you should know that others have traveled it, and I think we're doing well. We are still there, and the process can't go on forever. And at some point, we'll be completely in the incubator, and then after that, we are aiming to be a top level project. Thank you very much. Are there any questions? Yes.
About your tip number one, that interest is going down inside the company. Well, I read a column article a couple of months ago. GitHub is the place where old code goes to die. Yeah. So, and there was this message about a week ago that Oracle is laying off the mission control developers sourcely after open sourcing the project. So isn't that a major risk, or is going to Apache to solve that because you build a community? What's your take on that?
I'm sorry, what is the question?
So the risk about open sourcing a project is that the company is absolutely losing the interest. It's a little bit like what you were saying.
Yeah.
So is that a general observation, or?
That's it, but that's, no, but this is actually, once we are in Apache, as we are now, this is good. Because we want companies to, we want to have individual developers. If Oracle stops working on NetBeans, that's fine. We have a large community. That's the whole point. We don't want to be dependent on Oracle. We want to be an independent community that can stand on its own feet. And I mean, I work for Oracle. I contribute to Apache NetBeans. And there are a number of other colleagues from Oracle who contribute to Apache NetBeans. And there people from Boeing who contribute to Apache NetBeans, from Airbus. That's the way an Apache project works. We are not dependent on companies. We're dependent on the individual contributions of people who happen to work in companies or who happen to work on their own or whatever. What is nice is if companies say, we will give you, as an employee, dedicated time within your workday to contribute code to the project. That is nice, and that's definitely a wonderful thing. But even if companies don't do that, we have enough committers already that we're in good shape.
That